I'm Patrick Prince with the Tulsa World. I'm here with Eric Bailey, also of the Tulsa World. And 10 years ago, Eric was the TU beat writer and was there in South Bend, Indiana, to see TU's historic win over Notre Dame. Going into that game, Eric, what kind of chances did you give TU?
You know, Patrick, I really didn't know how they were going to play. I mean, this is a Tulsa team that had already lost two or three times heading into South Bend. It was a marquee game. And, you know, this wasn't a really good Notre Dame team, but still the mystique of the Fighting Irish, Brian Kelly, what they do at Notre Dame, it was going to be a tough task for Tulsa to go in and get a win. And you got to remember, they hadn't beaten a Power Five opponent in years. So, you know, the odds were certainly against the Golden Hurricane heading into this one.
At what point in that game were you thinking TU could actually win this?
You know, I think it was right after right after Tulsa had opening possession when they went down, marched down the field, and scored a touchdown. It was a G.J. Kennedy to Maurice Johnson pass. And you know, as easily as they scored that touchdown, I wondered, well, you know, maybe Tulsa's going to have a chance to win this football game. Little did I know that was going to be the only offensive touchdown of the game for the Golden Hurricane. So I think that opening possession when they stopped Notre Dame, then turned around and scored and went up 7-0, I think early on I said, you know, this could be a ball game.
Can you give us a sense of when TU sealed that game with Flanders' interception? What was the crowd like?
You know, it was crazy because you're right. And to this day, and I still wonder why Brian Kelly chose not to kick the field goal. He had an outstanding field goal kicker that he could have brought in. It was almost like a chip shot field goal for him, and they could have won the game with the field goal. But instead, they threw the ball into the end zone. Of all things, they didn't run the ball. They threw the football. There's a lot of bad things that can happen when you. That's what happened. John Flanders with an outstanding play in the end zone. And I'll just never remember how crazy the Tulsa sideline went and then just how silent Notre Dame Stadium was after that interception.
TU's coach at the time, Todd Graham, is now at Hawaii. A few months ago, you had an opportunity to catch up with Coach Graham, and I bet you he was more than happy to relive this game.
It was funny, Patrick, because I spoke to Todd just in general about getting ready for his first year as Hawaii's head coach and what he had to do to prepare, you know, within a pandemic. That was the goal of the story. And not only catching up, just, you know, this was different for him. He chose to talk about this football game almost as much as he did about his current team. You can really tell it means a lot to him. And, you know, to this day, he still has a picture of that interception in his office. It's going to follow him wherever he goes. So I think it's still, you know, 10 years later, it still means so much to him to go into South Bend and get a W.
Well, be sure and pick up a copy of the Sunday, October 25th, Tulsa World. We have two full pages looking back at this great TU win. Some great stuff by Eric, Kelly Hines, Bill Haston. So check it out. And of course, you can read it all at tusportsextra.com right now. Eric, thanks for your time.
Thanks, Patrick.